I now invite our chief guest, Dr. Minesh Mehta, to speak and share his thoughts with us. Dr. Mehta has always been, the go-to speaker whenever you're attending a meeting. And for the youngsters in the gathering, I can, already let them know that this is going to be something that you will enjoy listening to. So, Dr. Mehta, please.
So Sapna, in the US, we call that a setup. But Sapna, Rakesh, Prita, organizers, friends, ladies and gentlemen, I'm humbled to be invited to come here. I'm here as an observer, and I'm here as a cheerleader. Today is the 10th of the month. This is my 10th trip to India. This center, Proton Center, represents one face of emerging India. But there are many faces of India. And I'm going to take you through my journey of the first face of India that I saw, to this face of India, but more importantly, to the future face of India. My very first face of India went like this. I got on a steamship, and it took me 10 days to arrive to the port of Mumbai, where a bunch of porters unloaded metal trunks on their backs off of the ship platform, down to the waiting old dilapidated ambassador car, on which these were loaded and driven to the narrow streets of Princess Street in Mumbai, where the street was so narrow that they had to be unloaded and put on a horse cart to be taken to the house of a family member where we were staying. 9 floors above, without an elevator, going up with those trunks, climbing up, spending the next 3 days on a steam train into Gujarat to visit the home of my great-grandmother, who cooked with wood on a stove made out of clay. And I remember the stinging burns in my eyes and telling my great-grandmother that I was never going to visit her again because I could not stand the smoke in my eyes. That is one face of India. Today we have the Proton Center, cutting-edge, state-of-the-art treatment, best-in-the-world care, that opens up access to millions, not just in India and South Asia, but the entirety of this region. This transformation, just in my lifetime, is amazing. It is inspirational, but it's not enough. It's not enough because, yes, in many ways, India and you have caught up with the rest of the world. But catching up is not the goal. I spent most of my professional career in a state in the United States called Wisconsin, very, very tiny place, well known for its cheese and well known for its football team, the Green Bay Packers. The Green Bay Packers had a legendary football coach, Vince Lombardi, who said, when you catch up with the competition, you are second. And do you know what second is? Second is first loser. Second is first loser. Don't be the first loser. Win at what you do. Because winning is the only thing that matters. Win at all costs. This nation today, with what you have, the resources, the population, the technology, the opportunity, catching up is not enough. You have to lead the world. You have to show the world what is next. With proton therapy, with cancer care, with novel technology, you have this opportunity in your hands. So as an observer and a cheerleader, I'm encouraged that you will be able to do this, that you will be able to fulfill this dream, you'll be able to deliver. And that rather than coming here to deliver addresses and trying to teach people, we will be coming here to learn. That's what I'm looking forward to. Thank you very much.